Welcome back to our channel. So today we'll be reading Aladdin and His Wonderful Lamp. Aladdin and his mother lived long ago in a town far, far away. They were very poor. Every day Aladdin went to the marketplace to find work, but there was never any job for someone his size. Then one day, a stranger said, "Would you like to earn a gold piece?" Aladdin was very excited. One gold piece could buy so much. "I have a job for you. Someone just your size," said the stranger. "Follow me." The man led Aladdin out of town. They went along for many miles. When they came to a mountain, the man stopped. "Make a small fire right here," he told Aladdin. Aladdin was puzzled. What did the stranger plan to do? Aladdin picked up some sticks. He made a small fire. While the fire burned, the man began to say many strange words, words that Aladdin did not understand. Suddenly, a piece of the mountain began to open like a door. Behind this door, there was a hole. The hole was big enough for someone Aladdin's size. "Inside you'll find an old lamp," said the man. "Bring it to me." "Go in there?" asked Aladdin. Yes, of course," said the man. "That hole is the only entrance. Now hurry, it does not stay open for long." The stranger watched as Aladdin crept down some narrow steps. "Don't stop to take anything but the lamp," he called. The steps led to a great room filled with gold pieces. Aladdin wanted to fill his pockets, but he did not stop. He knew he must hurry. The next room was even bigger than this room. There was a tree. On the tree there were jewels. The jewels looked like fruit. Under the jewel tree lay an old lamp. Aladdin picked up the old lamp and started to go. Then he thought, "No one will mind if I take a few jewels to show my mother," and so he did. Suddenly, he heard the stranger calling to him. "Come back, the hole will close." Aladdin turned and ran. He came to the narrow steps. "Faster, faster," cried the man. But Aladdin could not make his feet go any faster. "Throw the lamp," said the man. "I must have that lamp." "I'll bring it," called Aladdin. "There's no time," said the man. "The hole is going to close." The stranger held out his arms. The lamp," he cried. The hole in the mountain grew smaller and smaller, and then it disappeared. Aladdin was trapped inside the mountain all because of the silly old lamp, he thought. Aladdin rubbed the old lamp sadly. At once, there was a great puff of smoke. Whoosh! Out of the lamp popped a genie. "What's your wish, O master of the lamp?" asked the genie. "My wish," said Aladdin, "that's simple. I wish I were home." Before he knew what had happened, Aladdin was back at his house. His mother was glad to see him, and she was amazed to hear his story. "But how sad," she said, "all those riches, and here we are as poor as ever. Maybe we can sell the lamp if I polish it." She took a cloth and began to rub the lamp. At once, there was a great puff of smoke. Whoosh! Out of the lamp popped the genie. "Your wish, O master?" he asked. "I wish we could have some supper," said Aladdin. "I'm hungry." At once, a feast appeared on silver dishes. After they ate, Aladdin's mother put away the silver dishes. One by one, Aladdin took the dishes to the marketplace to sell. This way, Aladdin and his mother were able to buy all the things they needed. One day, Aladdin went off to sell the last dish. On his way, he saw the Sultan's daughter. She was riding in a sedan chair. The princess smiled at him. Aladdin had never been so happy. He dropped the silver dish and ran after the sedan chair. "I must talk to her," he thought. Aladdin followed the sedan chair into the Sultan's palace. Two palace guards were standing by the door. "I want to see the princess," Aladdin told them. "A poor lad to see the princess?" said the guard. "Send him to me," said the Sultan. Aladdin was led into the palace. There sat the Sultan himself. "I have come to see the princess," said Aladdin. "If you want to see her, you must bring me a present," said the Sultan. "I have something right here," said Aladdin. He gave him the jewels from the cave. "Perfect," said the Sultan. "Now go put on your finest clothes and you may see the princess." Aladdin walked home sadly. He looked for one more silver dish. He could sell it and buy new clothes, but all the silver dishes were gone. But there was the wonderful lamp. As soon as Aladdin rubbed it, the genie appeared. Aladdin asked him for some fine clothes. Quicker than quick, Aladdin found himself dressed like a prince in the middle of a palace. The Sultan and his daughter were coming down a long walk. Aladdin bowed to the Sultan. "My name is Aladdin," he said. "I'm here to see the princess." The princess laughed. "I saw you in the marketplace," she said. "Come now, princess," said the Sultan. "This is nobody from town. This is a prince. We must welcome him into our home." Soon Aladdin and the princess were married. Now Aladdin was rich and important and happy. He never needed the genie again.
Thank you for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed Aladdin and his wonderful lamp. And stay tuned for another book read coming soon. Take care. Bye.
Bye.